But let's be honest, guys. Here in the South, we have our own bullshit, right?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm speaking, of course, of fibromyalgia. I got the fibromyalgia! Round of applause. Anybody here have a friend or family member suffering from fibromyalgia? Well, good news. No, you don't. For you see, it's bullshit. It's not real. Fibromyalgia is as legitimate as the boogie-woogie blues. For those of you who don't know, fibromyalgia is an alleged disease that's the grown-up equivalent of a little kid saying, I don't feel good. What's the matter, honey? You got a tummy ache or your head hurts? No, I want to watch TV. That's fibromyalgia. That's the WebMD clinical definition. And I'm not just being some old curmudgeon. I mean, there's no proof. You can't see fibromyalgia in an X-ray or a CAT scan. You can't detect it in the blood. You can't diagnose it through any kind of skin samples or anything like that. Do you know how they diagnose fibromyalgia? Well, your doctor sits you in a chair, asks you 12 questions. If you get 10 of them right, congratulations. You got yourself fibromyalgia. What type of opium would you like? That's not science. I don't trust a medical exam you can conduct via text message. That's just a drug deal. And since this is a comedy bit, let's ask ourselves, what kind of questions are they asking here? Okay, ma'am, I'm gonna test you out for fibromyalgia. Question one, do you ever feel tired or out of breath any times? Oh yes, I feel tired all the time. Wait a minute, let me get this straight. A 55-year-old, 400-pound woman feels tired sometimes? Well, that don't add up. You just baffled science, ma'am. Gonna need some follow-up questions. Okay. Question two, do you like OxyContin? Oh, yes. I like OxyContin. I like to get OxyContin and buy OxyContin and sell OxyContin and use the money to buy more OxyContin. All right, two for two. Question three, can you pronounce fibromyalgia? Well, let me see if I can use it in a sentence. Oh, please don't repossess my car. I ain't been able to work because I got the fibromyalgia. Well, that's wrong. But mispronouncing it's actually the right answer. So you're doing great. Go pick up your scripts. I ain't buying it. I guess it's just that it just bothers me that people fake this thing to get to wrap themselves in sympathy. They make it like part of their identity is that they're this fucking victim that deserves a little extra deference, a little more care, and shouldn't be held responsible for anything in the world, you know? It really fucking bothers me. Especially when there's people like me who are suffering from legitimate diseases. And I'm not trying to get up here and cash in on my illness or anything, guys, all right? I'm not trying to Tignataro my career or anything. I want to get there on my own. But since you brought it up, I'll tell you about it. Apparently, according to my physician, I have a hitch in my giddy up. And it's inoperable, so. I'm not dying from a hitch, I'm living with a hitch. The hitch started in my giddy up, quickly spread to my get up and go. Guys, the level of pep in my step, dangerously low. And we've tried everything, guys. We tried likes and shares. Nothing seems to help. Nothing. And that's how I make fun of fibromyalgia.
Thank you. For the record, I don't actually have a hitch in my giddy-up. So if you do, don't write emails or anything. I'm just checking. Nothing wrong with me. I got a little touch of the tuberculosis. That's it. Everything else is fine. So, hey, Hollywood, if you're listening, you got like 15 cancer comics. Check out. You ain't got no TB, guys. So give me a call. That's what Doc Holliday died from. So, you know, that's pretty cool.